Welcome back to Get Down to Business, the show all about small business, jobs, and entrepreneurship. I have a very, very special treat in store for you. I'm joined by Martha Marchesi, who is the CEO of JK Design, a branding authority with a powerhouse client roster, which honestly goes on and on, but just to name a few, Johnson & Johnson, Philips, Priceline, Prudential, ADP, Tiffany & Co. I'm just going to stop right there. I want to talk, Martha, with you a little bit about, again, your practice, but specifically, I mean, you have quite the reputation, certainly with that client list, and you are honestly the subject matter expert in everything talking creative. Our listeners can't see you, but you certainly pride yourself on the brand names and those identities, and specifically, we're going to talk about emotional intelligence. So before we get too deep in the conversation, Martha Marchesi, welcome to the program.
Thank you so much for having me.
Absolutely. It is an absolute honor. There is a tremendous buzz, Martha, out there advocating the power of emotional intelligence in modern marketing and branding endeavors. Let's talk a little bit about that. Why is that the case? And what's some of the trends that you've been seeing just out there in industry as a whole?
Of course. Well, if you think about it, what is EQ? It's really understanding your customer. I think it's knowing what's important to them. It's looking at things through their lens. And above all, it's creating an emotionally driven, empathetic story that's going to connect with them. I mean, think about all the buzzwords we're hearing today. Empathy, transparency, authenticity, honesty. These have become expectations by consumers. You know, we do a lot of work in the B2B space, and it's no different with customers there. People want to know that you share their beliefs, their values, that you understand their needs. And if you do that, you do it well, it leads to the most important thing of all, and that's trust. So I think today it's about building trust with consumers. That's really what we're seeing, is that trust is at the bedrock of engagement. It's at the bedrock of retention with your employees. Trust really is at the heart of all of it.
It sure is. I couldn't agree more. And in fact, there was a 2023 emotional intelligence market study, which we'll link in our show notes. I'm citing heavy growth. That's in a quote of 49, almost 50 billion. That's right, with a B, US dollars by 2027. Exemplifying the extent on mastering EQ versus IQ and taking brands to exciting new levels of success. So I know that's something that you analyze closely, telltale signs that a brand lacks emotional intelligence. So many of our listeners tuning in, you know, are just getting their businesses started. They're very focusing on honestly bringing in their first client, their fifth client, their 15th client, and so on. But at some point, folks start taking a step back. And I see this from certainly hosting the show for 10 plus years and actually developing that brand. So Martha, from your experience in not only working with big companies, but frankly, consulting and helping folks in developing that brand, what are the things that they need to pay attention to in the early stages of that brand development?
That's a great question. And I want to start by saying it's not hard to build authentic EQ. You just have to put in the work. And I think there are some fundamentals. The first is you need to invest in research. You need to keep a feedback pulse in place. You need to really, really understand your customers. So if you don't start with that fundamental understanding, you can't build an authentic emotional connection. I think the second thing is take a look at your values. Make sure that A, you're communicating them out, and also that they reflect who you are. Think about it. As a company, you are always growing, you're evolving, you're changing, and you've got to make sure that your values are a current reflection of what you stand for. So examine your values, make sure they reflect you as a company, and then really communicate them out well. And that's a big part of building trust. And then the last piece of it is you've got to create an emotionally driven story. You know, that's what we do. We help companies build those stories all the time. And I think it's important to know that you've got to build a story. If it's built on understanding your customer, if it's built on reflecting authentically who you are, and you put those two together, you have a really good chance of building a strong EQ foundation for your brand.
Absolutely. And you know, I'm laughing on this side of the microphone, because when you talk about storytelling, that's something we talk about, honestly, almost every single week on this program is storytelling. And to be honest, Martha, you know, actually for small businesses, I actually think that that storytelling, frankly, comes easier than in some of the large brands and companies that we mentioned in the start of the program and talking about those introductions. And actually, a small business owner and entrepreneur, the ability for them to tell their story authentically, which is I've been underlining on my sheet of paper in front of me quite a bit. I think it's so much easier. Would you agree?
Oh, absolutely. And you know, there's a fundamental passion when you're an entrepreneur, you're starting out, you're very passionate about your brand. And I think you're right. It's very easy to build and a very authentic emotional story where sometimes larger brands can lose sight of that connection. They're established, they're big. And I think they can get a little lazy or assumptive about, you know, who they're trying to connect to. And those bonds can get weakened over time, or as we've seen over and over and over, there's so much change in the marketing landscape and companies are going through transformations. They're merging with other companies and suddenly that identity is shifting and with it, that strong connection that they need to make with customers. So for bigger brands, they really need to pause and take a look at where they are, who they are, and how they're communicating. And that's where we come in and help a lot of companies do that. And we can look at it through a new lens for them and help them kind of reinvigorate their message and their story. So I think, yes, you're right. It's easier when you're starting out to really be able to connect with who you are as a brand emotionally.
And one of the things that, you know, we can talk about perhaps after the break is that innovating phase. But no, great notes. I'm taking over here. I'm chatting with Martha Marchesi, the CEO of JK Design, a full service creative agency with a powerhouse roster. We've been talking about some of those brand names. Very, very impressive. We've been talking about storytelling and developing that EQ, but authentic storytelling. We're going to continue our conversation with Martha in just a very quick moment. Don't touch that dial. You're listening to Get Down to Business, and we'll be right back. Welcome back to Get Down to Business, the show all about small business, jobs, and entrepreneurship. I'm chatting with Martha Marchesi, who is the amazing CEO of JK Design. Been having a great conversation talking about emotional intelligence, EQ. And, you know, Martha, just before the break, I mentioned that word innovation, because I think especially when you're talking about small businesses, but as small businesses become big, it requires a little bit of a different sort of hand at storytelling and starting to change things up. One of the biggest changes that we saw is certainly COVID. So what's that post-COVID world and why is this topic more important than ever?
Well, you know, I think we are working in such a different way. We see remote and hybrid. And what we've seen is that it's more challenging than ever to keep and make connections. And I think it's just a very, very different world. It's a more fractured world. So I think EQ and that thread of emotional storytelling is so important in being able to find consumers where they are, meet them where they are, and be able to connect to them. You know, one of the things we're seeing is how important corporate social responsibility matters today to customers. It really, really does. And we've been helping companies tell their ESG and diversity, inclusion, and sustainability stories. And that matters a lot today. It's frankly, corporate responsibility is white hot. And we've seen a bit of greenwashing happen where companies and brands are being taken to task for being, quote, fakers. So I think today it's not enough to say you have a commitment. You need to prove you have a commitment. And this is where transparency and honesty are key. So again, your relationship with your customers is going to be so much stronger if you're upfront with them and let them know where you are in the journey. So I think today, too, it's so important to tap into what matters. Things like corporate social responsibility, keep a pulse on the landscape and make sure that your stories are front and center, that allows you to connect with customers.
Yeah, absolutely. Honestly, I couldn't agree more. But I want to zoom out for just our remaining minute or two. I want to talk about your passion and how you got into this line of work, JK Design. And I mean, it's really inspiring what you're doing and the subject matter expertise that you have on this topic. Martha, how did you get going and why do you continue to sort of hammer home on this messaging?
Because we're expert emotional storytellers, and I understand how powerful emotion is in storytelling. And that what it can do for a brand and what it can do for its customers. And a quick side note, EQ is just as important on the inside as it is on the outside. We do a lot of employer branding work and we see how important it is to connect with your talent. Let them know who you are, what your values are, helps you retain talent as well. So we understand how important emotional storytelling is across all audiences across the entire spectrum, inside to outside. And so I think we look at everything through that lens to make sure that as a business, as a brand, you're connecting emotionally across all those audiences and all those touch points. So, amazing. You know, that's really what we're all about.
Amazing. No, I really, really appreciate you sharing that. And I've been taking good notes over here, and I know we'll make sure we get folks in touch with you via our show notes, but that's perfect segue. How can we get a hold of you and your team if we want to just discuss this idea of emotional intelligence, whether it's for big business or small business?
Absolutely. Well, you can find us at jkdesign.com. That's J as in jelly, K as in koala bear, jkdesign.com. You can reach out directly to me, Martha M. at JK Design. Happy to connect, happy to talk to anyone about how we can help them build out those stronger emotional connections that will really help move their business forward.
Oh, that's awesome. Fantastic. Again, Martha, really appreciate you sharing your expertise, your passion with our listeners. We're wrapping up here on the show all about small business jobs and entrepreneurship. Check out our sponsors, Tom Mirabali, independent agent for everything health insurance and affordable care. You could contact him on his website, healthplanchicago.com, or give him a call, 630-863-3477, 630-863-3477, or again, his website, healthplanchicago.com. Just mention Get Down to Business. And speaking of Get Down to Business, make sure you subscribe, rate, review, and share on your favorite podcast app. Just make sure you subscribe. Rate, review, and share makes it even easier for others to find the program. Get on my website, syklein.com. I honestly love to hear from listeners. I love to get show feedback and hear who you think would be a great guest on this program. That's a wrap for us here. Have a great week ahead. We'll see you next Sunday at 6 p.m. Right here on M560 The Answer. Have a great week to success. Let's get down to business.